Philip K. Dick's Electric Dreams is the newest sci-fi anthology series on the block. So, does it have the kind of futuristic flair needed to compete with a show like Black Mirror? Hi everyone, I'm David Griffin, and here's what I thought of the first season. Telling a compelling science fiction story isn't easy, especially when the writer is building a world from scratch. Some of the best examples within the genre, like the reimagined Battlestar Galactica, take present-day issues and place them into a futuristic setting. The simple but effective style helps to ground these new worlds with drama we can relate to. We see a strong example of this in an episode titled Real Life, which follows policewoman Sarah as she escapes the pressures of her stressful job by using a very lifelike VR simulation. Sarah's virtual experience has her sharing a mind with game designer George as they pursue violent offenders in the simulation. In our present-day world, aside from the money it takes to purchase a game, the consequences of playing too much Zelda aren't very serious. I mean, you might need to shower and say hi to your family and friends every now and then, but in this episode, the interactive experience can have terrible consequences. It makes you think twice about going for that one last shrine in Breath of the Wild. Family is another universal theme Electric Dreams deals with in the standout episode Father Thing. Veteran actor Greg Kinnear stars in the father-son story that effectively explores what it means to grow up. Kinnear's character is simply referred to as the father, and his son Charlie suspects that something's not quite right with him. There is a clever sci-fi element here that I won't spoil, but what makes Father Thing so great is how well it handles the non-sci-fi aspects of the narrative. The episode delves into Charlie's evolving understanding of who his parents are. As he starts to mature, Charlie notices when his parents' relationship is in trouble. It's a timeless story that showcases a child growing up and becoming aware of the problems his parents are facing, even when they try to hide it. Electric Dreams does stumble with The Hood Maker, one of the few stories that definitely needed more time to breathe. The story centers around a future without advanced tech, where the only way to achieve long-distance communication is by using a group of individuals with telepathic abilities called Teeps. The Teeps are abused and live in horrific conditions. It feels reminiscent of an X-Men story where a group of mutants are second-class citizens because of their unique abilities. Despite an impressive cast featuring Richard Madden and Holiday Grainger doing the best with what they're given, the story feels rushed and incomplete. It's like the writers are trying to force a whole season's worth of story into one episode. Even the best anthology series will have a few bad apples like The Hood Maker, but thankfully for Electric Dreams, they are few and far between. Overall, there's a lot to get excited about. The man behind Blade Runner had some wildly imaginative ideas, and it's great to see them brought to life by a very talented group of writers and directors. Thanks for watching. For more sci-fi anthology goodness, check out our Black Mirror Season 4 review and our video of the top 10 Black Mirror episodes, and be sure to like and subscribe to IGN everywhere you like to watch.